ओके, वेलकम बैक। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट देयर वर टू टाइप्स ऑफ मल्टीप्रोसेसिंग सिस्टम। वन इज एसिमेट्रिक मल्टीप्रोसेसिंग, द अदर वन इज सिमेट्रिक मल्टीप्रोसेसिंग। एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड दैट इन एन एसिमेट्रिक मल्टीप्रोसेसिंग सिस्टम one of the processor will be acting as a master and the other processors will be acting as workers, and the master processor will allocate jobs for the other processors. Okay, whereas in a symmetric multiprocessing architecture, all the processors will be treated as equal piece and the jobs will be allocated to these processors by the operating system. Okay, now this diagram explains the symmetric multiprocessing architecture. Here you can see there are three CPU, that is three processors, CPU 0, CPU 1 and CPU 2. Okay, so this entire block is a CPU, and each of the CPU has its own registers and cache memory. And there is the main memory RAM, which is shared by all these processors. Okay, for all these CPUs. So this is one example for symmetric multiprocessing architecture. Okay, so the architecture may vary. Okay, see here, cache is inside. In some other architecture, cache may be outside of the processor. Okay, this is one example where you have multiple CPUs and they are sharing a single memory, and all these processors are placed in a same system. So this is an example of symmetric multiprocessing architecture. Okay, so the next thing what we will be discussing is multiprocessing can be of two types. Multiprocessing can be of two types. One is called as multi-chip. The other one is called as multi-core. So what does it mean? See, multi-chip in the sense, the previous example, whatever we have discussed, this is an example for multi-chip. Actually, this is an example for multi-chip. Let me call it as MC, multi-chip. Why it is called as multi-chip? Because CPU 0 is placed in a separate chip. Okay, chip in the sense it is an electronic device, in a separate electronic module this CPU is placed. Similarly, in a separate chip CPU 1 is placed, in a separate chip CPU 2 is placed. That is, each of these processors has its own chip. So this is an example of actually multi-chip system. Okay, so this is a multi-processing system which uses multiple chips. That is, for each processor it uses a separate chip. There is another type of multi-processing which is called as multi-core. Okay, so some of you may be having a laptop with multi-core, dual core. So dual core in the sense what? Or multi-core in the sense you will have only one chip. Here you can see in this diagram, so there is only one chip. This single chip contains two cores. So core is nothing but processing element. So this particular chip contains two cores. So this is processing element one, and similarly it contains another processing element which we can call it as processing element 2. So this is processing element 2. So this particular computer is having a single chip, but this particular chip contains two processing elements. So in one chip you have two processing elements. So this is an example of multi-core multi-processing system. Okay, so what is the difference between multi-core and multi-chip? In a multi-chip, based system, each processor will be placed in a separate chip, whereas in a multi-core, multiple cores will be placed in a single chip. Okay. So actually, performance-wise, multi-core system performs better than multi-chip systems. The multiprocessors with multi-core system performs better than the multiple processors with multi-chip. The reason is it is easy for the operating system to deal with multiple cores within a single chip rather than dealing with dealing with processors in different chip. Okay, so that will increase the work of the operating system. So actually, the multi-core systems performs better than multi-chip based multi-processing system. And another thing is, all multi-core systems are multi-processing systems. Okay, all multi-core systems are multi-processing system. That is, if something is a multi-core, then it is also multiple processor. Okay, but all multi-processing systems may not be multi-core. Okay, for example, this is a multi-processing architecture, but can you call this as a multi-core architecture? No, you cannot call it as multi-core, because nowhere you have two cores or more than one core in a single chip. So this is just multi-processing. This is not multi-core. Whereas if you come here, this is multi-core, because there are two cores in a single chip, and it is also multi-processing because you have two processing elements. Okay. So the point is, all multi-core systems are also multi-processing systems, but all multi-processing systems may not be multi-core systems. Okay. So this is the difference between multi-chip and multi-core. So nowadays, most of the laptops are coming with multi-core processors. Right? Fine. Okay. So the next thing what we will be discussing is clustered systems. So what is a clustered system? See, in a clustered system, we will combine two or more physical computers will be clustered together, and the work will be distributed among these computers, and the work will be get done. Okay, so for a clustered computer, for a clustered system, you need a separate software. You need a separate software which can work with the multiple computers. Okay, because you have to cluster separate computers. Okay. So why we do this? So basically, we do this to provide high availability. So basically, we do this to achieve something called as high availability. What does it mean by high availability? So the definition of clustered system is what? Multiple computers will be clustered together, and there will be a cluster operating system which takes care of interconnecting all these systems and getting works done through all these systems. Okay, so why we go for clustered system in the sense to achieve something called as high availability? So assume that you are creating a cluster with say 10 computers. Now, due to some reason, two computers fails also, still the system will be running because you have another 8 computers. Okay, so this is called as high availability. If something fails, that will not affect the entire system. Okay, in spite of failure, the entire system will survive, and the service will continue to happen. So that is what is called as high availability. And we have two types of clustering. One is called as asymmetric clustering. The other one is called as symmetric clustering. Okay. In asymmetric clustering, what happens in the sense, one of the machine, one of the machine will be in a standby mode. So if you have a cluster of 10 computers, 9 computers will be doing the actual job. The cluster operating system will divide the job among these 9 computers, whereas one computer, it will not be doing any job. It is in standby. It will just observing all these 9 computers. It will be just observing all these 9 computers, where all these computers were working properly or not. If any one of the computer fails, if any one of these 9 computers fails, then this computer will take that particular job. It will play the role of the computer which has failed. Okay, so that type of clustering is called as asymmetric clustering. And the second type of clustering is symmetric clustering. So in symmetric clustering, you have multiple nodes. So here the different computers are called as nodes. You have multiple nodes. So and all the nodes will be running some applications. Okay, and all the nodes will be running some applications. There will not be any node which will be in standby mode. Every node will be running some or other application, and every node will be monitoring each other. So if you have 10 nodes, all the 10 nodes will be performing some function, and also they will be monitoring each other. So say for example, out of the 10 node, say 8th node fails, then whatever the work which is being carried out by node 8, that will be distributed among the remaining 9 nodes. Okay, so this is how symmetric clustering works. So basically symmetric clustering actually it provides better performance than asymmetric clustering, because here you are effectively utilizing the resource. You are not underutilizing any resource. Okay, so this is the two types of clustering, asymmetric and symmetric. Okay, so sometimes so some of the clusters are also called as high performance computing. Okay, so because if you add more nodes to the cluster, the performance will obviously increase. So the clustered systems are basically used for high performance computing, to increase the performance of a computing. Okay, and the operating systems or the softwares that is running in a clustered system should be able to perform something called as parallelization. Okay, so the applications which is running in a clustered system should be able to achieve something called as parallelization, because you have multiple nodes, and the work should be shared among all the nodes, and the application should be capable of doing that. Okay, so they should support parallelization. Parallelization means distributing the work among all the nodes. Okay, and sometimes what happens in the sense, all these nodes, I mean the collection of nodes is called as cluster. All these nodes may share a common memory. So let us assume there are 3 nodes, node 1, node 2 and node 3. But these 3 nodes may be using a same memory. They may be using a same memory. Okay, so even though they are different pieces, even though they are physically different pieces, they may share a same memory. So this is possible in case of server architecture. Okay, they are using a common memory. So now what happens in the sense, if say this is node 1, this is node 2 and this is node 3, if node 1 is using the memory, then nobody else should use the memory. So if node 1 is using the memory, then the memory should be locked for node 1. Okay, so because node 1 is using that. Okay, so at that time node 2 and node 3 should not be able to access the memory. Okay, once node 1 finished the accessing, then the lock will be removed. Now node 2 or node 3 can use. Again, if node 3 is using, once again it will be locked for node 3. It is only node 3 can access. Now node 2 and node 1 cannot be able to access the memory. So this concept is called as distributed lock manager. So the clustered operating system should be able to do all these things. Okay, So there is a concept called storage area network. Storage area network, in the sense, the storage device can be shared among multiple nodes which are even separated by several kilometers. So this concept is achievable this is achievable by using a method called as SAN. So SAN stands for storage area network. Okay, so you might have heard LAN and WAN. LAN stands for local area network. WAN stands for wide area network. Okay, so LAN means the computers which are interconnected within a building. That is LAN. The computers which are interconnected within, say, 10 or 20 kilometers from one building to another building, that is called as WAN. Similarly, there is something called a storage area network. Okay, it means there can be one storage or multiple storage which are interconnected, and it can be shared among more than one nodes. Okay, so that concept is called a storage area network. So this diagram basically explains the concept of storage area network. So here you have a computer or a node. This is computer one. You have another computer or node, computer or node two. You have another computer, computer three or node three. And these computers are interconnected, and they may be separated by several kilometers, but still they are sharing a same storage. Okay, they are using the same storage. Okay, so this is an example of what you call storage area network. Okay, so using clustered architecture, this type of network is possible, right? Fine. So that's it about clustered systems. So we'll stop for the day here. So to summarize, what we have discussed, in the sense, we have discussed that we have discussed an example for a symmetric processing architecture, and we have discussed that multiprocessor can be of two types. It can be either multi-chip or multi-core. Multi-chip, in the sense, for every processor there will be a separate chip, whereas in multi-core, a single chip can have multiple cores. Okay, all multi-core architectures are also multi-processing architectures, but not all multi-processing architectures are multi-core architectures. For example, this architecture is not an multi-core architecture, but it is a multi-processing architecture, right? And then we have discussed clustered system. In a clustered system, what happens, in the sense, more than one PC will be interconnected to form a cluster, and it will run a special operating system called cluster operating system. So mainly we go for clustered system to achieve something called as high availability. That is, even if one of the node fails, the system will continue to survive. There are two types of clustering, asymmetric and symmetric. In asymmetric clustering, one of the node will be always in the standby node. It will keep observing the other nodes. If any of the other nodes fails, then this node will take care of that job. In symmetric clustering, all nodes will be doing the jobs, or it will be running its applications, and also it will be monitoring other nodes. If any of the other nodes fails, then the work of that node will be distributed among all other nodes. Okay, so actually symmetric clustering performs much better than asymmetric clustering, because it effectively utilizes the resources. So clustered systems are used primarily to achieve something called as high performance computing, that is, to increase the computational power. And applications running in the clustered system should be able to achieve something called as parallelization. That is, whatever the task that the application want to do, it should be able to distribute among the multiple nodes. Otherwise, the nodes will be underutilized. And in some cases, the nodes in the cluster may share the common memory. In that case, if one node is using the memory, then the other node should not be able to access the memory. then the memory should be locked for the other nodes to avoid from accessing. So the clustering operating system should ensure that, and this is achieved by using a concept called distributed log manager. Okay, and one of the latest developments of clustered system is something called a storage area network, where multiple nodes share the same storage, and these multiple nodes may be separated by several kilometers. Okay. Here, storage in the sense we refer physical storage, some secondary storage devices, right? So this is called storage area network, because the storage is shared among multiple devices which are separated over several kilometers. Fine. Let us stop here. Thank you.